Well, welcome everybody. It is another edition of Locked Down Discs, and it's one I've got to be honest that I've really been looking forward to. The man in screen is none other than John McGrath, and I'll tell you where John and I became acquainted was through actually our mutual working at a Powerade Performance Academy. He was that good. I said to the Powerade guys, they've got to have him back next year, and they have. And so I get to see quite a lot of him, probably not enough. But John McGrath, great to have you on, because I'm really looking forward to chatting to you and also your selection of music. But welcome to Lockdown Discs.
Thank you, Neil. Thank you for having me. It's awesome. I always cherish every single conversation we've ever had. They're always fun, and there's always fun, laughter, and something intriguing, something growth as well in them all. So I'm looking forward to it. Thank you.
Well, normally I would introduce my guest, but in your case, I'm actually going to ask you maybe just to give a brief synopsis of your background and how you got into doing what you do. Because I've heard you sort of present and talk, and there's no ways I could repeat the eloquence of that. So you can do that in a moment. I just want to remind folks that have joined in. This, of course, is Lockdown Disc. It's loosely based on the old BBC Desert Island Disc. We're all in lockdown at the moment, and I thought it'd be great to get hold of some interesting people, and they can tell me the five songs that they want to take into lockdown with them, and two movies and a book. And, of course, the idea is to get some indication of the guest's taste, the castaway's taste, and also why they listen to what they do. So, John, give us a brief synopsis of your background.
Okay, well, I'm Irish by birth, I'm South African by choice, and I mean that I've chosen to live here despite everything, despite all the chaos and the craziness. I still love this country. You have a very special calling to be here. I grew up in relative poor circumstances, and I always knew that I would elevate myself some way through the vehicle of strength. Everyone's got their vehicle. Everyone's got their thing that they're incredibly good at. And somehow from a young age, I knew it was strength for me. So I started developing that. I knew that strength wasn't fixed, as most things are not. And I started working on that. And through the years, I ended up rowing for Ireland. I ended up doing karate and kickboxing for Ireland, and through that I developed other feats of strength from there, I'm sure, which we'll talk about later. And through those, I got to really explore who I am and bring that gift to the world. And so that's what I'm here doing. I'm involved. I've got my own foundation here in South Africa, busy in the communities and in the townships of Bekwane, in particular, just outside Paarl, where I live. Busy with that. These are my passions. Sport, I think, is the vehicle of which I can express and help others as well express who they truly are. But I'm not limited to that. I think sport is the vehicle that I've chosen. But after that, people can see there's a lot of metaphors in sport and analogies that people can easily understand. And it's a great way to communicate to the rest of the world.
Absolutely. So, well, welcome to Lockdown Disc. As we go along, we're going to talk about fortitude when being locked down, and there's the physical element, of course, of staying physical, but perhaps even more powerfully at the mental side. And having looked at you, you've got a wonderful and interesting, as I knew you would, selection of music. So, John, take us into your first track. What is the first song that you're taking into lockdown?
The first song is I don't have my list right next to me. Can you cue me on that one?
I can prompt you. Yes, I can prompt you because I have it all worked out here. So I don't know whether they'll probably be in the order, but let's start with the one that you came up first, which is the great man Michael Jackson, "Man in the Mirror."
Yes, "Man in the Mirror." Thank you for that. This is an epic song, and particularly at this time. You know, this time as well. If you were to ask me last week what were my favorite five or a month ago, they'd probably be slightly different, you know? But right now in reflection, these are really the important ones I feel right now, if I was to go to the island. So "Man in the Mirror" is a challenge to us all. It's a challenge of to reflect. And at this time, will we ever have a time again to reflect like we have right now? Possibly not. And, you know, there's a chance to reflect and repair, you know, to come to terms with things in the past, we all have to reflect and to repair and, I suppose, to forgive ourselves about it. Because if it doesn't get repaired, it gets repeated in our lives. And we're all the same. I'm the same as anybody else. So now is our time to reflect on who we truly are, repair, and to move on, and to use this opportunity, this song, and the challenge that's in this song to grow, essentially.
Okay, well, let's listen to Michael Jackson. I mean, again, a trend that we've seen on these lockdown discs are unique artists who, the moment you hear them, you know who they are, whether they be Freddie Mercury, Terry Payne, of course, went for Elvis Presley, and big names like that. We heard Hugh Masekela during the week. So here's Michael Jackson with the song Man in the Mirror. Let's listen to a few tracks. This is John's first track that he's taking into lockdown. Such a relevant lyric right now, of course, with some South Africans literally with not enough food to eat, and time for us all to reflect, because wherever we might be on the pendulum of where you believe you are, there is always somebody probably worse off, and we should never lose sight of our privilege. So a very apt song right now. And what a voice, Michael Jackson, a distinctive, and I suppose like many of these big artists, you could have taken four or five different Jackson songs.
Yeah, I mean, you know, there is the Earth Change song. There's many, many classics that he has. I like the ones that he sang about meaning, rather than just the pop ones. For me, obviously, that would, yeah, but you could have, but for me right now, that is the one. This is the one that's important. This is the challenge for us all, and the challenge that we're gonna have to rise to, and I believe we will, but it's this is the challenge of our generation.
Absolutely. Okay, so track one, Man in the Mirror. Let's move straight along to your second choice. I'll tell you, I'll prompt you. So these folks I've never heard of, and I loved the sound. So you're going to have to tell me a little bit about them. The song says a lot about the lyric. It's called Love Letters to God, and it's from, I assume you pronounce the guy, Nako and the Medicine for the People. Nako Bear, actually, is his name. I Googled him and found him fascinating. Mm-hmm. But Love Letters to God, tell us why. Why are you taking that track, John?
Yeah, again, I mean, it's to do with the words. I love the lyrics of it. I love the funky way he's put it together. It's very contemporary. Obviously, they've got an indigenous root to everything that's inherent in it as well. But I love the message in it. You know, it's a message of still, it also comes with its challenges. Particularly for the Native American people who've been challenged tremendously over the last few hundred years. And his response is, you know, to sing about it and to open up his heart about it. Mm. So I really love the words. I love the lyrics. I love where he's going with it. I suppose I love his humanness as well, and how beautiful that is, how vulnerable he is. And so the challenge is to become more human, to become, and it's that's a, it seems to be a trend with the song, with the music tonight.
John, you'll appreciate this. I've been very blessed to be doing this show for a week or so, not in the least because I've just had my own horizons expanded, and at times I'm reminded of movies. So for example, if I go back, Terry Payne reminded me of Casablanca was the one movie that he took with him, and the other one was One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. And yesterday Alan Committee was talking about The Three Amigos, because and The Party, two great comedy shows. So it's fantastic because you get to hear from individuals, but it also triggers your own appreciation of music. And the reason I say that is because this song struck me straight away, and there was a resonance there. So I'm going to play it for the folks. This is Nako Bear, Medicine for the People. It's called Love Letters to God. Let's see if we can play this. Okay, let's see if we get it. It actually starts a bit slower, so here we go. Love Letters to God, John's second track.
Sometimes it's hard to be my brother's keeper, love. So you let love in. Baby, I am home and awake, and you're skimming. It's crazy how we wear our ceremony. Always be open to your path and your journey. Yes, she cradles my loneliness. A home and a forest nest. Universal test. Feel the weight of my love. Put your hand on my chest and rest. In the cradle of my arms, the battle that we face is a place where our scars come from. And to pick up the gun, my love, we are destined to teach these ones to be brave and never run away. Courage is birthed from the womb on the first light of day. Yeah, the day you were born, you came out perfect. Never to be torn in silence. Never been so loud in the violence. Never been so proud of a people.
You know, it's one of those songs, John, I'm loath to turn down because, as I said to you, it struck me immediately as something that I'd like to explore further. And hopefully, I'm sure a couple of other people will as well. We now know who Nako Bear is. And I can hear exactly why you'd want to take that. There's a great emotion in the track.
There is. It just speaks to your heart, doesn't it? You know, there's something about it just hits you here. It's not only here, but in all great things, I suppose, grab us here as well. You know, there's I believe that there's a tremendous connection between the head and the heart anyway. You know, that I believe that, you know, that we have our own intelligence here, our gut instinct and our, you know, so we should be a little bit more led by our heart. And again, there's a lot of challenges there as well in that song. I think his one line is that so many parts to a heavy heart, you know. There's beautiful lines and an awful lot of learning that can take place. And I can just listen to that song again and again and again.
Fortunately for me, I've now downloaded it. So I'll be getting a lot of airtime in my car when eventually I can get back in the
right.
John, lovely. Two great tracks. I would ask you for the movie, but actually because of I know what you've actually chosen to take, I'm going to ask you to tell me about your book first, because that leads me on to talk to you a little bit about your own history and the people you've met. So what book are you taking into lockdown?
Well, I jokingly sent you, the first one I sent you was the Collins' DIY book. That would probably be the most practical and useful, but the one I would take with me was, it's the life story of a guy called Joseph Greenstein. His stage name was the Mighty Atom. He was born in the 1890s in Poland and immigrated to the United States. And he became a performing strongman in vaudeville. Vaudeville was a genre of entertainment from about 1868 until 1914. The movie sort of killed vaudeville, but some of the vaudevillian actors and performers went into the movie, such as Charlie Chaplin, Laurel and Hardy, all of those guys. So vaudeville, you would come to a hall, it used to be called music halls here in South Africa, and you would be entertained by singers, by acrobats, by dancing girls, and performing strongmen, guys who performed phenomenal feats of strength. And at a certain stage in my life, I read this book, and it changed my life significantly. There's something that attracted me to it. I was drawn to it for a reason that I can't explain. And I just went with it. And I ended up meeting there's another character in the book called, there was a prodigy of the Mighty Atom. His name was called the Slim the Hammerman Farman, who was his prodigy. And I ended up traveling to the United States to train with him. So my lineage goes all the way through. And I ended up performing with his son, Mike, on TV on Fox News in the United States just a few years ago, where Mike, aged 93, pulled a car with his teeth, age 93. And this is the people I like to hang with.
Well, I Googled that earlier today. I Googled that. It was remarkable footage because, folks, if you go on there, you will see literally Mike Greenstein, who is 93, and he's working with John, pulling a SUV with his teeth. Incredible stuff. Mind you, I did see you on there as well, bending with your teeth. A barb, well, not a barb, it's a metal rod. So that was incredible in its own right.
It's a bar.
And I've seen you do some of this. So when you and I had this chat and you said to me, oh, can I do the odd thing? Obviously, I was going to say, please do. So have you bought anything to show us on something? Because I can tell you, you'd be the only person so happens, down just doing it.
Just so happens that I have here a deck of cards. You can see that they're sealed. It's a new deck of cards. I haven't broke the seal. Cards come out. Trying to keep the cards on camera all of the time. Make sure that they're all out. Okay, so we've got 54, including the two jokers. Watch this deck of cards.
You.
I've
asked you this before viewers watching. Where is the power in that? Is it in the wrists? Oh, he's doing it again. Into a quarter.
Here we go.
John, where is the power in that? Is it up here? Is it mind over matter? In the wrists? Is it in the fingers?
It is. Yeah, we don't have any strength in our fingers, but there isn't any muscles there. But the power is here. I mean, I do exercise my I've got forearms like Popeye as well. But mm-hmm. It comes in, you know, a daily discipline and a daily routine of doing things, which brings us in almost to another conversation. You know, having the discipline to do something consistently. You don't have to be great to begin, but in order to be great, you must begin. And I do something every day. I visualize every day. I train every day. I'm always looking for ways to improve myself. I'm looking for this lockdown as a challenge, you know, to become stronger, to do other things, to learn new things. And so, you know, you've got a growth mindset. That's the important thing. And to believe as well that we have a governor that's in our mind, like the governor that's an engine in a car, and it keeps us in a safe place. And I managed to be able to go through that, to switch that off, to be able to go through to our full potential. All of us have got, you know, live lives where we're giving maybe 30 to 40, 50%, but very few go all the way through. And I've sort of learned techniques through the martial arts and through these feats of strength that I can access these powers, which we all have. But they don't come easy, and they don't come without paying some for it. Mm.
Okay, well, that was fabulous.
Maybe one more?
Leave that until the end. I suspect right at the end of the show, I'm going to want you to nail it. So,
well said.
So, fantastic. So, let's move. So, that's the book, not surprising. What about the first movie?
Okay. The first movie is a very unusual choice, and I was like flabbergasted that you knew it, because most people I talk to don't. Mm. So it is it's an Italian movie, and it came out in the early 70s. Mm. It's called Cinema Paradiso, and there are two versions of it. There's the normal version and there's the extended version, and it's a love story, and it's beautifully told, and there's something just special about it, the setting and what that cinema made, you know, for in his life. And in the life of the community, and something when we all grow up, that special place, it might have been the football club or the boxing club, you know, that was a place in your life at that time. And like everything, it doesn't last and things fade, but the memories live on. And it's about that time, not trying to, there's a time at the end when they could have recaptured it, you know, when they could have went back and reconnected, but they chose to leave it in the past. And sometimes that's the best thing to do, to never try to recreate and recreate these moments, but love it for what it was and move on and be open to the flow of whatever the world takes you.
It's a beautiful movie. I remember it well. I think I probably saw it for the first time when I was studying at UCT, and I always gravitated towards these Cinema Nouveau movies. So that's certainly where I would have picked up and watched it. It's a wonderful choice to take. We're going back to the music. In no particular order, I'm going to do one next that you sent through, which is called The Farm. Oddly enough, I should have heard of this, but I hadn't. Or maybe I had, but I couldn't place it. Because it was used, as it turns out, in the Football World Cup of 2006 in Germany. The song was. Although the song was before that. So tell us a bit about this. You're taking The Farm, All Together Now.
All Together Now, and here we are in this country, All Together Now, for better or for worse, All Together. There's something that captures you again with this song. It's just a sense of being together. It is inspiring in a way, and it is uplifting. There's something about it that's uplifting, inspiring. There's nothing phenomenal in the lyrics, but I think the way it's put together and the sound of it is just one of these songs that just lifts you, and we all need that. I find music to be incredibly inspiring. I play music, not all day, but many times during the day. We need to be constantly inspired, particularly at these times, because it's easy to fall down. And I think music just keeps me up and keeps me going. And this song is one of my go-to if I need a pickup.
Well, this is going to move you. And I suppose they're called The Farm, so I should say it should move you. And here is The Farm with the All Together Now. Here we go. Again, a very catchy song, I have to say. I can see why they used it for the World Cup Germany 2006. Let's have a listen. All together now. Yeah, it was quite interesting. I ended up Googling this song as well. It was actually about, he wrote it. Because he's at the Farm, are a band from Liverpool. He wrote it actually about Michael Fitt, the old politician who was criticised for not wearing the right clothes, apparently at a war memorial. And he said, "Well, why are people worried about what they're wearing? It's the thought process." And the soldiers that died would have been happy to have had someone of his nature there. So it's a song with a lot of meaning and depth. The second movie, John, this doesn't surprise me that you went for that, because I visualize you, especially after you've done that with the cards, being able to match Mel Gibson in Braveheart quite comfortably.
Yeah, this just, again, there's something about the movie Braveheart. There's something about the underdog, isn't there? We all like the underdog. We like the story, and it's just such an, even the cinematography is wonderful, the beautiful highlands of Scotland. The way it was made as well was phenomenal. And so, yeah, there's something about the yearning for freedom. I mean, and it's an important thing now, isn't it? You know, to be, now we appreciate freedom. I think we'll appreciate freedom like we never appreciated before when all this blows over. So, It's quite pertinent at the moment as well. And freedom isn't free, is it? You know, one's got to struggle for freedom.
Yeah.
It comes at a price. So yeah.
Yeah, two nice movies, Braveheart, which will inspire many. I mean, they are people who continue, many of us, to re-watch great movies, and they never tire. And that certainly is one of those that is inspiring. Let's move on to the next one, if we can. And, well, here's a woman who is fantastic. I think we'll appreciate many. Alicia Keys, you're taking Empire State of Mind. I had the great pleasure of watching Alicia Keys perform live at the Champions League final in Milan, actually. But she obviously was in Japan, so she didn't sing this, Empire State of Mind. But a great pianist, a great lyricist, and just a wonderful performance. Why Alicia Keys?
Yeah, I mean, because of all that you've said, number one. But, I mean, she has also the ability to move you with this song. And I've got a special affinity with New York as well, you know, having been there performing. And there was a time when I had a very serious back operation about 5 years ago. And as a result of it, I set myself an impossible goal to break a world record in New York City 18 months after the operation. And this song had the ability to move me and inspire me. And I listened to this song, literally, if it was a record, it would have worn out. And there's just, with the words, I mean, you see and feel New York with the way she sings it. And she's absolutely amazing, incredible woman. I really love her. She's a phenomenal artist. And this is just such a great song.
Well, let's have a listen. This is John's fourth track, Alicia Keys, Empire State of Mind. First time in lockdown discs that I've actually had, let me just turn it down, that I've had goose flesh. And somebody, any artist, I believe, who can sit, whether it be an Elton John, Billy Joel, who can sit at a piano like Alicia Keys, John Legend, and just do that. Lionel Richie, these guys, just a remarkable talent. Yes.
Unbelievable. She's got it. She's got the ability to move me. It's a dangerous song for a guy to sing along with, though. You end up going, woo!
I wore special underwear. Only
in the shower.
Absolutely. Okay, John, one last song. But before we get to the last song, you showed me a nail. A long nail. Show it to us again. And please don't tell me that you're going to bend that, because
I'm going to give it a try. So this is much harder than a 6-inch nail, guys. It's an American nail called a 70 penny nail. So it's not to be compared to. So I'm just giving it a wrap here, guys. I'm not putting, this is just a piece of cloth I just wrap it with. And I feel like Alicia Keys. It's more difficult to do this sitting down than standing up. Trust me. So I just wrap it here. hold it here.
That's incredible. So, I mean, the power that's that you've administered, for want of a better word, to that nail is incredible. Because I would imagine, like anything, you need the leverage. So that the smaller the nail, the more difficult. If it's longer, you've got leverage. Would that be right?
Yeah, it is. That's absolutely accurate. It is very difficult, but you've got to just make your mind up. You know, for me, here I am. We're live. We're doing this show, and I can't fail in this moment. I cannot fail in front of you and the audience, and I've got to do it. I don't have a choice but to do it. And if you make yourself into that position, if you box yourself in, I don't have a choice. I've got to do this. Generally, you will do it. But we live in a world where, oh, try it, maybe we won't. So I'm not into that. I believe that you've got to do it. You've got to push through it. Does it hurt? Yeah, it hurts, but you've got to get there.
Sure. Well, that's why we've got you on lockdown disc, because I know most of my viewers are thinking, if we want to go into lockdown, can we take John with us? Particularly if we need a few nails bent and cards. And thank heaven, actually, you didn't get confused, because you just did Alicia Keys. If you'd done that with your own car keys, then you wouldn't have been able to leave the house when lockdown's over. I think I've got one song left, John, of yours. And this, I don't know the band at all. I had to, again, go and find Switchfoot, as they're called. The song is Where I Belong. Yeah. So I'll give you an opportunity to tell me why you chose it. Why are you taking it into lockdown as your fifth and final track?
Where I Belong, because I've always felt a bit alien in the world. I've always felt a bit strange in this world. Yeah, to be honest about it, that's quite true with you. I don't feel in a lot of ways I belong here. This journey on earth is a difficult journey for us all of us who live here. And I believe that we do go to another place when we leave here, when we exit. And it's about there. It's about what you do at that time. When I go to that other side, I want to be able to reflect and look back on my life and say, you know, job well done. You did something to make the world a better place. You improved yourself and you left the world a better place than what you found it. So again, it's a very reflective song. There's challenges in this song as well. I like this band Switchfoot, and yeah, this is Where I Belong.
Okay, let's listen to Switchfoot then. I'll switch it up. This is John's final track, Switchfoot, Where I Belong. Oh, sorry, I switched it off. That's not very good. Coming back on. Well, John, you've come up with some wonderful songs, I must say, that are inspirational. Just on that subject, when you train, and obviously you do a lot of training, do you train to music, or do you find that diminishes your focus, or do you use some kind of music to train?
Absolutely. Sometimes In fact, most of the time I do use music. I think we respond to music. I mean, if you're listening to something with a fast beat, and that, you know, I mean, before a football game, you've got music that raises the atmosphere. And so we respond very well to music. If you're having a nice meal, you like slow, soft music. So I love music like that. I think we are very responsive as human beings to the energy of music. And so I really do go with that. But sometimes I deliberately have no music. I put myself in a very Spartan environment where only I have to do it myself. And that's very important as well, that you don't get trapped, you know, because you're able to turn it on, you're able to do it without the outside stimulus as well. You have to be able to bring it from within.
Fascinating.
And I think that's the really important thing, that, yeah, that's the real power is within ourselves.
John, we've come to the end of our lockdown disc, but I must say I knew I'd enjoy it, and I have, not only because of your choice of music and movies and the book, which is fascinating because it brings some of your own personal history into it all, but also I think you've inspired us again, not only with what we've seen on screen, but the messaging behind it. And I'm going to ask you just to close out, because we obviously as a country are still in lockdown, and we need all the inner strength as much as anything else, and the discipline, because if we don't follow these laws of looking after ourselves and therefore looking after everybody in our community, we're going to be in a lot of trouble. So it's simple stuff to stay locked down, but we've got to do it.
Absolutely. At this stage, your psychology will make you or break you. Absolutely. And that goes to in every aspect of your life, but as what you're doing yourself and your family. And there's an irony here as well between, I know a lot of people, particularly millennials, may not like the word discipline, but don't think of it in terms of that negative connotation. I think freedom has a price for us all. And I think discipline is the price of that freedom. Discipline, whether you agree with it or not, you know, to stay in lockdown, to stay in your lane, do what's right for the world, not just for yourself. Do what's right for the country, not just yourself. What's that, think of not what you can do for yourself, but what you can do for your country, that John F. Kennedy quote. You know, that's appropriate at this time as well. And you know, to put the discipline as well, to put some structure around your life. This is a massive transformation here. And you know, when I work with teams and work with groups of people in corporates, we talk about this is the greatest transformation of the workplace since the Industrial Revolution. You now no longer have a compartmentalized life where you go to work, go to the gym, go to meet your friends, have a coffee, and you know, go to bring the kids to school. Now it's all in the one place. Your entire life is in the one place. And that is an incredible, I probably don't have to tell you of all people, but that is an incredibly stressful situation. And how to manage that takes time. And you need structure around that. We need structure in our own life to go for a walk for 20 minutes, to do some exercise, to breathe, to continuously challenge yourself, and to have a routine, to have a daily routine is absolutely awesome. You know, you can do it both ways. You can walk downstairs in the morning with your pajamas on, frump on the couch and send a few emails, you know, but that's not you at your very best. And the challenge for us all is to use this opportunity to bring out what's best inside us and what's best for the country.
Well, John, thank you very much for your thoughts. Thank you for sharing the time and your own performance levels and all the interest that you brought to tonight's edition of Lockdown Discs. It's Saturday night, so I'll let you go back to your other form of lockdown. But thanks very much for your time. And stay safe, stay strong, and hopefully we'll see each other after the lockdown.
Absolutely, Neil. Thank you so much for having me on the show. Very, very grateful. Thank you.